I welcome all the delegates back for the post-lunch session. I think without wasting much of the time, I call upon Dr. Kalpesh Satani to proceed with criteria 2 presentation.
Yes, good afternoon, everyone. Honorable Vice Chancellor, Dean HOI of various institutes, Director IQSE, and other participants. Now, without wasting much time, I will directly move to the criterion 2. Yes. Yes, now all of you knows, as Dr. Punacha explain in the morning, that the name of the criterion 2 is teaching, learning, and evaluation. Okay, proceeding further. Okay, now under teaching, learning, and evaluation, there are 7 key indicators. Now, these 7 key indicators are student learning, student enrollment and profile, catering to student diversity, teaching learning process, teacher's profile and quality, evaluation process and reforms, student performance and learning outcomes, and student satisfaction survey. Now, as such, in AQR, they have not given weightage of individual key indicators, but as Dr. Punacha told in the morning, that AQR is almost similar or a mini version of SSR. So the weightage given in the SSR can be considered here also in AQR. So total weightage of criterion 2 is 200 marks. So if you see the weightage, maximum, actually all key indicators are important, but the two main indicators are related to teacher's profile and quality and evaluation profile of the institution. Now proceeding further to different types of metrics in criterion 2, total 22 metrics are there. So among this total 22 metrics, 4 metrics are qualitative metrics, whereas 18 metrics are quantitative metrics. Okay, now we'll go individually to key indicators. Now, the first key indicator is 2.1, that is student enrollment and profile. Now, under this key indicator 2.1, there are 3 further indicators, that is 2.1.1, 2.1.2, and 2.1.3. All these indicators are related to admission process. So the admission officer and Department of Admission of the institution will be the responsible person for providing the data related to these key indicators. Now 2.1.1, that is a quantitative indicator, that is due consideration is given to equity and inclusiveness by providing reservation of seats to all categories during the admission process. Now this indicators is related to inclusiveness of reserve category students. Okay, whether your institution is providing reservation to different categories of students or no. Okay, so in this indicator, what data they ask from institution is number of students admitted from reserve categories and total number of seats reserved for this reserve category students. So these two numbers, so in earlier AQR we used to provide only numbers in this matrix, but this time along with the numbers we need to provide certain documents. So to support the given numbers, whatever number is given by admission officer, to support these numbers we have to upload certain documents to prove that this number are correct as of our knowledge. Now to support these numbers, we have to upload these documents like number of seats filled against seat reserved. That means whatever number of seats we have reserved, among this reserve seat, what are the number of seats that are filled. Second upload required is copy of letter issued by state government or central government. That means the every year, usually government actually issue a letter saying that these are the categories which should be reserved categories and should be institution should kept certain seats available for them for admission process. Okay, so according to that reservation category has to be arranged in the institution. Now in that, in the particular year, what all are the students are admitted, so full admission list also we will have to upload. Now every year, actually, institution needs to submit data related to admission of OBC, ST, and SC category of student to the government. But actually, for the deemed university like Sumandip Vidyapit, all the students who are admitted in the institution are considered as a reserve category student. But this is not applicable for other private and state universities. This is applicable only to the deemed universities. And another document which needs to be uploaded is initial reservation. So in a different program, what all are the number of seats, and in that total seats, what are the number of seats which are reserved for reserve category students. So under that, the data template which we will have to fill is number of seats reserved as per the government rule and number of students who are admitted in their category. Now moving further to 2.1.2, that is student demand ratio applicable to programs where state, central, common entrance tests are not conducted. Now this indicator actually asks like what is the demand of each and every program which is running into the institution. Okay, so what data needs to be provided by a Department of Admission is number of eligible application received during the year, that is total number of application received in all the programs which are running in the institution. Okay, and what are the total number of seats available? So on the basis of that, ratio can be calculated. Now to support that number, certain document needs to be uploaded is, that is first is data template. So this is a data template. So in data template, we will have to give detailed data, that is in each program, what are the number of seats and what are the number of application received under that specific program. So for an example, if 100 programs are running in the institution, then in the all 100 programs, we will have to give the numbers like what are the total number of seats sanctioned or available, and against that seats, how many applications received. Another data needs to be uploaded is document relating to sanction of intake. So the document has to come from admission office and certified by board of management that what are the number of seats actually sanctioned for that particular program. Third document is against those program, what are the numbers of application received. So same data we need to fill in the data template. That the fourth document we need to give is the details certified by the controller of exam or registrar evaluation, clearly mentioning the programs that are not covered under common entrance test and the number of application received for the same. So actually the second number and third number document relating to sanction of intake and extract number of application, that same document will have to be signed by controller of examination or registrar evaluation. So it has to be, that means it has to be certified by those persons. So as I told, this is a data template. We need to fill details. Now the third indicator under 2.1 is student enrollment pattern and student profile to demonstrate national, international spread of enrolled students from other states and countries. So this indicator basically asks that what are the number of students which are coming from other states or other countries for studying in particular institution. Okay, so again, admission officer or a department of admission will give data related to this metric. So what data actually needed is number of students from other states and countries for that particular year and number of students enrolled in that particular year. So to support those number, we need to give a detailed list of students enrolled from other states and countries with their programs. So further support to that list, we need to give admission order of all the students who are belonging from other states and countries. Along with the admission letters, we need to give domicile certificates as well as previous degree or matriculation certificate of all the students who belongs to other states and countries. And further, data template also has to be uploaded. Now, this is a format of data template. So in data template, we need to give enrollment number of all the students who have taken admission and belonging from other states and countries. Now proceeding further to criterion or key indicator 2.2, that is catering to student diversity. So under that, the first key indicator is 2.2.1 quantitative metric, that is the institution assesses the learning level of the students after admission and organizes special programs for advanced learners and slow performers. This metric, this key indicator actually asks that what are the measures being taken by the institution to assess and identify different categories of student based on their learning, that is slow performer, advanced learner, and what institution is doing apart from identifying what programs they are conducting for their betterment and advance in curricular and extracurricular aspects. So under this, we need to choose one or more options under that. So these four options are ADAPTS, measurable criteria to identify slow performers. Second is to identify advanced learners. Third one is organizing special programs for the slow performers and advanced learners. And fourth one is follow protocols to measure students' achievement. So actually for a good institution, if all four measures should be there in an institution for a better scoring. And Dean and HOI of the constituent institution and University SLSS, that is Student Learning Support System Coordinator, is responsible for providing data related to this key indicator. Okay, so under this certain document needs to be uploaded, like methodology and criteria for the assessment of learning levels and details of special programs. So under this, we need to give data and we need to give methodology, that is a policy, how the students are being identified or categorized into slow performers and advanced learner based on certain methodology and based on certain policies. And along with that, what are the special programs are being conducted? So details of that special programs conducted for slow learners and advanced learner has to be there in that document. Okay, so and second document is details of outcome measures. So in the first upload, what programs we are giving. So after certain periods of implementation of the program, we need to measure the outcome, whether really students are improving in curricular and extracurricular aspects. So we need to give details of outcome measures also. Third is pro forma created to identify slow performers and advanced learners. The same thing which we are going to upload in first upload is methodology and what policy is there to identify slow performers and advanced learners. The fourth one is consolidated reports to Dean Academics. That means at the end of the program, for an example, in an institution, if 4 years programs are going on, then at the end of the each year, each course students, there should be a consolidated report, and that report should be in a graphical format for better understanding. So that report, consolidated report, in fact, we need to upload. That should actually show the progress of students in both the categories, that is slow learners and advanced learners. Now under 2.2, second indicator is student full-time teacher ratio. So here they are specifically asking data for the preceding academic years. That means for which year we are filling the AQR, the same can be considered as a preceding academic year. So Dean or HOI of the respective institution will be responsible to provide this data. So under this indicator, what actually data is needed is total number of students enrolled in the university and total number of full-time teachers in the university. Actually, this indicator has to be supported by respective council. That means full-time teacher or recruitment of full-time teacher should be in accordance with the respective council or statutory regulatory authority. So whatever number is being given by the institution, that has to be supported by certain documents, and those documents again has to be uploaded under this indicator. So what document needs to be uploaded? The first one is list of students. That means all the students in all the programs, what all other students are admitted, that list of students we will have to upload. And along with that, list of full-time teachers we will have to upload. Yes. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Yes, thank you. And along with that, list of full-time teachers in that particular year only we will have to upload. So that list of teachers should be with the designation and their highest qualification. So actually this ratio should be in accordance with the respective council or statutory regulatory authority. Now, proceeding further to 2.3, that is teaching learning process. Now, this is a Yes, 2.3.1 is a qualitative matrix. Now, this is like student-centric methods used for enhancing learning experience. Now, this key indicator is actually asking us that what all are the student-centric methods are being used in the different respective colleges or institution for better experience of the student or enhancing learning experience. Just a minute, huh? Just a minute. Hello, am I audible? Hello?
Yes.
Sorry for the interruption. Yes, under 2.3.1, to support our qualitative answer, we need to upload a list of student-centric method institution-wise. Okay. And any other information, actually, if we have information like a geotech photograph using this student-centric method, we can upload it under any other relevant information. And the dean or HOI will be responsible for providing data related to this. Under 2.3.2, sorry, the institution has provision for the use of clinical skill lab and simulation-based learning. This key indicator actually is asking us related to skill training of the students of the institution. So the under that, we need to select one or more options we can select here. So there, what four options they are asking is whether institution has basic and advanced clinical skill lab facilities, has advanced patient simulators for simulation-based learning or a training, has structural program for training and assessment of students in clinical skill lab or simulation center, and conducted training program for the faculty in the use of clinical skill lab and simulation methods for of teaching learning. Actually, institution should provide, institution should have all the facilities related to this for better scoring or a better weightage. So here, Dean HOI and Director Skill Lab will be responsible for this. Hello, ha sir, good evening. Ha sir, આવી જઈશું સર. હા, આવી જઈશું. હા, 2.3.2 document. So here, what documents needs to support our selection of that four points? first need to upload geotech photographs of the clinical skill lab facilities and clinical skill models and patient simulators to prove. And this photograph, geotech photograph, should be there so that we can confirm that these facilities are existing in the institution itself. Now, second thing is list of training programs conducted in the facilities during the year. So if we have a clinical skill lab facilities, then definitely we are providing certain programs in that facility. So we need to provide list of all these training programs which we have conducted in the skill lab facilities. Now, in skill lab facilities, what all are the clinical skill lab models are there? So the list of those clinical skill models also we will have to provide. And we need to give further is proof of establishment of clinical skill laboratories. So under that, we need to give establishment of skill lab report that should clearly mention that when the lab was established, what are the skill training models are there. Okay, everything has to be there in clinical skill lab establishment later. So the further thing is proof of patient simulators for simulation based learning. So what proof we can give here to ascertain that this skill lab facilities we are having in the institution is we may show them bills of purchase of these mannequin or different clinical skill training models. We can provide them insurance of skill lab. We can provide them insurance renewal receipt also to prove that these are the patient simulators that are existing in the institution. And the last thing is report on training programs in the clinical skill lab. So in the second upload, what list we are providing, so details of that list and along with that programs in a similar format has to be provided in upload in criterion 2.3.2. And any other information, we can provide extra photograph if we have to support our answers. Now, proceeding further to 2.3.3, that is a qualitative metric. That is, teachers use ICT-enabled tools for effective teaching and learning process, including online e-resources. Again, in a qualitative metric, we will have to provide answer in 100 to 200 words. This metric is actually evaluating the efficiencies of the teachers in using ICT-enabled tools. Okay, so to support that, we need to give details of ICT tools which are being used by all the teachers for regular teaching and learning process, as well as we need to provide list of all the teachers we are using ICT tools. Ideally, all the teachers in the institution should use these ICT tools for teaching learning process. Now, 2.3.4, that is student mentor ratio. And again, this data has to be provided of a preceding academic year. So what data needs to be provided under this indicator is total number of mentors in the preceding academic year and total number of students in the preceding academic years. Now, in total number of students, all the students, all years of the students of all the programs has to be considered over here. And total number of mentors, actually all the teachers in the institution who are working are officially mentors. But again, if for a particular year, if they are not been allotted a mentees, it's okay, but they are all are considered as a approved mentor. So this data has to be provided by dean or HOI of the respective institution and central mentorship coordinators. So to support this number, we need to upload certain documents like details of full-time teachers and other recognized mentors and students. So under the details, we need to give a particular teacher, his or her designation, and what all are the mentors what all are the mentees allotted to particular mentor, and that mentees belongs to which years. So that is there in a details of full time. The second one is allotment order of mentors to mentee and records of mentor and mentee meetings. So here, as I told, all the staff working in the institution are considered as a approved mentor. So the allotment order of a mentor should come from Dean HOI of the respective institution. So actually during the year, all the mentees are meeting to their mentors, and whatever discussions are taking place between them should be recorded in a mentor's diary, and that record of mentor and mentee meeting should also be uploaded under this heading. Now, third is copy of circular pertaining to the details of mentor. So again, it is very much similar to first upload. So we will have to give
details of full-time teacher along with the circular from HOI or dean clearly stating this. These are the mentors and mentees given to a particular mentor. Yes. The fourth is approved mentor list. So as I already told, all the teachers are approved mentors. So again, this list should come from dean, HOI of the respective institution. The further is logbook of mentors. So here a blank logbook or a ideal field logbook can be uploaded over here, and a data template also. Now what data template is asking is the similar thing. What numbers we are giving is total number of recognized mentors and total number of student assigned to each mentor. Ideally, this ratio should be 1:1:10. So better the ratio actually is a better to score a good marks under this indicator. So the ratio should be 1:10. So one mentor should have maximum 10 mentees. Now proceeding further to 2.4.4, that is the highest weightage key indicator under criterion 2. Now 2.4.1, that is number of full-time teachers against sanctioned post during the year. So the dean and HOI as well as the registrar office is responsible to provide this data. So what data actually required here is total number of full-time teachers in that particular year and total number of sanctioned post in that particular year. So whatever numbers we are giving, we need to give certain documents to support that as usual. So what documents we need to give is list of full-time teachers and sanctioned post. Now list of full-time teachers will be given by respective HOI and HOD, whereas sanctioned post should come from registrar office, and that also should be certified by the head of the institution. And this, list of full-time teachers also has to be certified by the HOI dean. Now second is position sanction letter by competent authority. Now this position sanction letter actually can be according to the respective council or statutory regulatory authority. So this letter has to come from registrar office, and it is ideal if it passed through board of academics and or board of management. And to support the list of full-time teachers, that actually these teachers are really recruited in the institution, we need to also upload appointment orders of all the faculties which we are giving numbers in this metric. So all the appointment letters of all the faculties we will have to upload. And one more thing is data template also we will have to upload. Now the data template is same. So what data we have given, the numbers. So detail of that teachers we need to give, like name of full-time teacher, their designation, nature of sanction post. Ideally it should be full-time or a regular full-time, year of their appointment, and in which department they were recruited. So this is a data template of 2.4.1. Now 2.4.2, that is number of full, actually in 2.4.1 the target of recruitment should be 99% to 100%. So whatever a sanctioned post are there, against that same number of recruitment should be there for a better weightage of our answer. Now 2.4.2, number of full-time teachers having PhD or a master degree, which makes them eligible for PhD guide. Okay, so this actually PhD coordinator should be responsible to provide this data. And what data needs to be provided by him or her is number of full-time teachers with PhD or other approved PG degree. That means they are eligible as a PhD guide, and total number of full-time teachers in the institution. So to support those number, we need to give list of full-time teachers who are eligible as a PhD guide, as well as copy of their guideship letter or authorization of research guide letter. Okay, and the data template is same, but we need to provide a detail like what is the name of the teacher, in which year they have got their master degree or PhD degree, and whether they are recognized as a PhD teacher, yes, and what are the total number of those teachers. Actually, the institution should emphasize that all teachers should pursue their PhD degree, and as many as PhD teachers are there in the institution, it is always better for the institution. Now 2.4.3, that is teaching experience of full-time teachers in number of years, that is cumulative experience of all the teachers. Okay, so here what data they are asking is in the institution, all the teachers' cumulative experience in year divided by total number of faculties we need to give. That is a cumulative experience. So this data has to be provided by Dean HOI of the respective institution. So to support the cumulative experience, we need to give certain data like list of full-time teachers, including their designation department and total number of years of their teaching experience. Now here they are specifically asking teaching experience. Along with that, to support that list of full-time teachers, we need to give experience certificate of those full-time teachers. And along with that, we need to give data template. Now, data template is the same thing, but we need to give in details like name of the full-time teachers, their designation, their year of appointment, department, and number of years of teaching experience. So ideally, in this metric, if our answer comes around 11 to 12 years on an average teaching experience of each teacher, that is always better. So our target should be 11 to 12 years. So the institution is requested to recruit faculties who are having a good experience. Now 2.4.4, number of teachers trained for development and delivery of e-contents, e-courses, video lectures, demonstrations during the year. Okay, so here actually is asking that how many teachers of the institutions have been trained for development and delivery of e-contents. Okay, so under that, what data is required? This total number of full-time teachers and what are the numbers of teachers which are trained for development and delivery of e-contents. So whatever numbers are we are giving here has to be supported by documents. So those documents are list of teachers which are trained for development and delivery of e-contents and certificates of their completion of training. So whatever teachers have been trained for development and delivery of e-contents, we need to give certificates of their completion of training. And if the program to train teachers has been done in the institution, then we need to provide reports of that e-training program also. Then after taking training, obviously all the faculties are developing and delivering contents, obviously. So whatever contents have been developed by those faculties and delivered by those faculties has to be hosted in the higher education institution's website. And whatever contents we are uploading, so list of those content also we will have to upload here in key indicator 2.4.4. So here in data template, same numbers we have to give, that is total number of teachers and name of the teachers who have trained for development and delivery of e-contents, and provide link to the few courses. That is whatever e-content has been developed by the faculties that is kept on HEI's website, that link directly we can here give. Ideally, all the teachers of the institution should be trained for development and delivery of e-content. As Dr. Punacha told in the morning that every year institution should organize two programs, one in the first 6 months and second program should be in the later 6 months. Ideally, all the faculties, but bare minimum, at least 80% of the faculties should be trained for development and delivery of e-content. Now 2.4.5, that is number of teachers, that is number of full-time teachers who received awards and recognitions for excellence in teaching, student mentoring, scholarships, professional achievements, and academic leadership at state, national, international levels from government recognized agencies, registered professional associations, academics during the year. This indicator is actually asking that what all are the number of teachers who are receiving awards and recognition for excellence in teaching, student mentoring. That means the highest experience and highest quality of the teachers. Okay, this data has to be provided by Dean and HOI, Dean and HOI of the respective institution. So what number has to be provided is number of teachers who received award and total number of full-time teachers. Now to support the numbers, we need to upload e-copies of award letter. That means whoever teacher got recognition from government, non-governmental organization, we need to provide certified e-copies of their award letter. And along with that, we need to provide a data template. That is number of teachers, title of their award, state level award or national or international award, and who all are the agencies, or who is, what is the name of the agency who provided the award. Now, ideally, if all the teachers are receiving awards, it is always better. But nevertheless, at least 10% of the faculty should receive awards in this matrix for better weightage. Now, proceeding further to evaluation key indicator 2.5, evaluation process and reforms. Now, under that 2.5.1, number of days from the date of last semester end, year-end examination to the date of declaration of result during the year. That means the date of last exam and date of declaration of result. So duration between the last exam and the day results are being declared. Okay, so what data needs to be provided here is number of days from the last exam and number of semester end, that is year-end exams conducted. So here, cumulative days of all the programs, as I told, the duration has to be given here, and total number of semester or year-end exam has to be given here. So the COE, that is Controller of Examination, that is Department of Examination, will be responsible to provide data in this key indicator. So to support this number, we need to upload data like list of programs and dates of declaration of last semester end and year-end examination results. So what all are the programs, and in those programs, how many year-end or semester end exam was conducted, we need to give. And after how many days the examination result was declared, that also has to be given. The second thing is report from Controller of Exam or annual report mentioning the relevant details. So under first upload, what details we are giving, the same detail has to be there in annual report of the examination section. And under that, we need to give data template also. And data template, we need to give details like what is the program name, program code, and what all are exam conducted, like semester end or year end, and last date of last semester end or year end examination, and date of declaration of result of semester end or year end examination. Now, ideally, as less number of days result come, it is always better. And as mentioned by Dr. Poonacha in the morning, that if the result declares within 30 days, it is always good. But for a better weightage, the result should be declared within 15 days of the exam. Now, proceeding further to 2.5.2, again, quantitative metric. Number of students complain or grievance about evaluation against the total number of students appeared in the examination during the year. That means whatever number of exams have been conducted in an academic year, and all the students who have appeared, among all the students, how many number of students had complained or grievance regarding the evaluation. Okay, so under that, the data again has to be provided by Department of Examination. So here, what data needs to be provided by them is number of student complaint, that is all the number of students who have their complaints or grievance against the evaluation process, and total number of students appeared in the examination in that academic year. Okay, and to support those number, what documents needs to be uploaded are certificate from registrar or COE about student grievance. Okay, that means COE should clearly state or should give certificate that this many students had a complaint regarding a complaint or grievance regarding the evaluation process. And as you know, that in the higher education institution, as the student applies for or complains about evaluation, there should be meetings of the relevant body. So the minutes of those relevant body has to be also uploaded over here. And along with that, list of complaints and grievances also has to be uploaded. And along with that, all the students' list also has to be uploaded here. So the data template, what they are asking is total number of complaints and total number of students who have appeared in the examination. And it is always better in the institution if less number of or very minimal number of student complaints, or in fact, it is better if no student complains about evaluation process. Now, 2.5.3, that is evaluation related grievance redressal mechanism followed by the institution. Okay, so under that, they have given five headings that how institution is having evaluation, grievance redressal mechanism being followed in the institution. So they have given five options under that. Whichever option is applicable to the institution, we will have to select. So these five options are double valuation, multiple valuation with appeal process for retotaling, revaluation and access to answer script. Second one is double valuation, multiple valuation with appeal process for revaluation only. Third one is double valuation, multiple valuation with appeal process for retotaling only. Fourth one is single valuation and appeal process for revaluation. Fifth one is grievance redressal mechanism does not exist. As you can see, the last is minimal and the first one is maximal. So it is always better if the institution selects the first option for a better weightage. So to support our selection, whatever number we are selecting, but to support our selection of that point, we need to upload documents, like we need to give links to the examination procedure and revaluation procedure followed in the institution. And that link has to be there in the IHEI's website, that is Higher Education Institution's website. Again, second thing, report, that is annual report of the COA, which we have uploaded in the criterion 2.5.1. Same report has to be uploaded over here, but that report should have clearly mentioning grievance redressal mechanism. And here also data template is there, that the data template remains same for 2.5.2, that is redressal mechanism, that is grievance or complaint about evaluation process. Now 2.5.4, that is a qualitative metric that says reforms in the process and procedure in the conduct of the evaluation or examination, including continuous internal assessment to improve the examination system. This question is actually asking that what all are the reforms are being undertaken in the institution for better conduction in the exam or evaluation and for continuous assessment. So ideally there should be reforms every year to better about the evaluation process. So here we need to give qualitative answer in 100 to 200 words, keeping in mind following points like examination procedures. Now process is integrating information technology. Okay, continuous internal assessment system, competency-based assessment, workplace-based assessment, self-assessment, OSCE, OSPE. Okay, so this answer should include all these points. And to support our qualitative answer, again, we need to provide web link, like details of examination reforms. So we need to give details like what was the reforms and minutes of that reforms that was presented in a board of academics or board of management. Okay, in which date that meeting was held. So details of that reform has to be given here. Now 2.5.5, that is status of automation of examination division using examination management system along with approved online examination manual. Okay, so here actually they want to ask like what information technology or what automation actually is being adopted by the institution for better examination management system. So here they have given five options and we need to select applicable options. So these five options are complete automation of entire division and implementation of examination management system. Second one is student registration, hall ticket issue and result processing. Third one is student registration and result processing. Fourth one is result processing and fifth one is manual methodology. Now, as you can see that the bottom is having a list automation and the first one is having a maximum automation. So ideally institution should select the first. So in the sense, ideally institution should having complete automation in the exam management system. So if we are selecting first option, then we need to give certain documents to support our selection of point. That is, we need to give snapshot of EMS. That is, automation is there. That means we have to give snapshot of the exam management system. And if we are using EMS, that means we have purchased or developed the software. Then we need to have that purchase of order of the software also. And then again, we need to have that annual maintenance contract of the software also. And at last, we need to give that what is the present status of the automation, and along with that invoice of the software. And we can always give screenshot of the software also. Along with that, annual report of the examination, which we are uploading in 2.5.1, 2.5.3. So same annual report we need to upload here. But again, that annual report should have clear detailing about status of automation in exam management system, and that has to be passed through governing council. Now moving further to 2.6, that is student performance and learning outcomes. So under that key indicator, the first one is 2.6.1, that is the qualitative metric. So what it says is the institution has stated learning outcome graduate attributes as per the provision of regulatory bodies, which are integrated into the assessment process and widely publicized through the website and other documents. So here the basically what they are asking is, as per the regulatory body or statutory regulatory council or respective council, whether institution is having stated learning outcomes as well as graduate attributes, and whether institution is having a proper strategy to assess that learning outcome and graduate attributes, and all this thing has to be there on the higher education institution's website. So here we need to give qualitative answer in 100 to 200 words, keeping in mind of learning outcomes and graduate attributes as well as assessment process. So to support our qualitative answer, we need to provide web link like relevant documents pertaining to learning outcomes and graduate attributes, as well as method of assessment of learning outcome and graduate attributes. Ideally, the syllabus of each program will be having a stated learning outcome, course outcome, as well as graduate attributes will be there. And along with that, method of assessment also will be there. So we can provide those documents as web link in the institution's website. Now 2.6.2, pass percentage of final year students in the year. Now this metric is asking regarding what all are the numbers of students which are graduating from the institution. Okay, so again, Department of Examination will be responsible to provide this data. So what data they need to give is total number of students who appeared in the exam, and from that appeared student, how many number of students who actually passed those final year of exam. Here they are asking only final year exam, not first year, second year or other courses. Okay, so here final year, that means how many students are graduating from the institution. Okay, so whatever number we are giving over here, we need to give certain documents to support that number. Okay, so what documents we need to give? We need to give is list of all the programs and list and the number of all the students who appeared in that exam of that particular program, and all the students who have passed from that appeared students. Okay, again, the third point is annual report of the examination. So again and again, we are uploading over here the annual report, which we have uploaded 2.5.1, 2.5.3, 2.5.5, same annual report we are going to upload over here. But again, we need to make sure that that annual report should have details about examination results of all the programs. Okay, so ideally more number of students are passing, it is always good. So this is a data template, same thing they are asking, whatever number we have given earlier in 2.6.2, same thing we need to give here, but in detail. Here we need to give number of student appeared and number of student passed as per the program. So in each program, how many number of student appeared, and in that, how many number of student passed we need to give, and a cumulative answer we need to fill over here in 2.6.2. Now proceeding further to last key indicator, that is 2.7. That is student satisfaction survey. This is quantitative metric, that is online student satisfaction survey regarding teaching learning process. Here actually the NAC is evaluating students' experience regarding their learning in the institution. So here we need to provide certain data to the NAC, and NAC will be directly assessing student satisfaction through students through online mode. So what data we need to provide to the NAC is, we need to provide name, gender, category, domicile, nationality of all the students who are enrolled in the this academic year. Along with that, there should be a unique enrollment number of each student. They should also have a unique mobile number and email ID, and their degree or program, and their year of joining. So all this data we will have to provide to the NAC, and NEC will be assessing satisfaction of the student in learning process directly from the student itself. Okay, so here the dean or HOI of the respective institution will be responsible to provide this data. So this is about 2.7.1. Now this is about criterion 2.2. It is a big, actually big metric. I tried to simplify it and tried to explain you in a simplified manner. So if you have any doubt, you can ask.
Screen share karna padega.
Okay, if no doubts right now, then I will hand over to Dr. Pratik Karya. Dr. Pratik, but you can always ask question later on in the question answer session that will be held tomorrow. Yes, Dr. Punacha. Yes.
Dr. Pratik Karya is not there anyhow. Dr. Nirmal Shah will take over. He will be speaking on criteria 3.
Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, you are.
Yes. So,
I'm not interested in.
Respected Vice Chancellor, sir, respected Dean, Principal, and coordinators of various cells and sections. Good afternoon, everyone. Here I am going to discuss with the criteria 3, research, innovation, and extension. First indicator, it is 3.1, promotion of research and facilities. Under that, first metric number 3.1.1, institution has a well-defined research promotion policy and same is uploaded on the institutional website. It is a qualitative metric, and here we have to provide a qualitative answer in 100-200 words on the institutional research promotion policy, assigned budget for research and its utilization, method for implementation and monitoring. In the support of this document, we have to upload the minutes of meetings of Governing Council, Syndicate Board of Management for the year related to research promotion policy adoption. Second upload is document on research promotion policy or any other relevant document. So here we are generally uploading with our research compendium and the minutes of meeting of Board of Management where that research compendium has been adopted. So here we have to give the qualitative answer for this question regarding the well-defined research promotion policy. Next metric, metric number 3.1.2, the institution provides seed money to its teachers for the research. Now this is the quantitative metric, and for that we have to provide the data in the given format, where we have to provide the name of institution, name of the project for which seed money has been. Duration of the project, name of the teacher working in the project who is receiving the seed money, amount of seed money in lakhs, and year of receiving the seed money. And for this, in the support of this, we have to upload the sanction letter of the seed money to the faculty. Rashi? The particular project which is passed out in a minutes of meeting of the research committees,
sanction
or approval letter, we have to upload here in the reference. Along with that, budget and expenditure statement signed by the financial officer.
Madam, phone
seed money that we have to upload, that had been carried out with the CFOMM and the charter accountant will be signed for that. That we have to upload it along with the balance sheet of the particular financial year. Third upload is a list of teachers receiving the seed money and details of seed money received as per the data template provided or any other relevant document. So this activity will be carried out by director research, HOIs of the all the institution and account department. So they have to maintain the data for that and they have to provide the data. Another metric, 3.1.3, number of teachers awarded national, international fellowship, financial support for advanced studies, collaborative research and conference participation in the Indian and overseas during the year. So with that, we have to give the data in given format where we have given any financial support to our any faculty in the any fellowship or any other advanced study or any collaborative research which they are doing with any other institution or universities. And along with that, in any financial support provided in any conference participation. So all the data together we have to provide here in given format. So where we have to give the name of teachers who is receiving the financial support, name of particular award, fellowship or conference participation, year of the award where he or she has participated or awarded that particular award, and awarding agency. Now here with this template, we have set certain target for that. So here, if you in the fourth audit, if you see that minimum 30% of faculty should be fulfilled with this requirement. Out of our total faculty, minimum 30% should have either get financial support for attending any conference or any collaborative research or any advanced studies. So that target we have to achieve in the given timeline. So in the support of that, we have to upload certified e-copies of the award recognition letter for the teachers where they have taken the financial support, list of the teachers and the national international fellowship details as per the given data template and any other relevant information. So director research, HOI of the Consulting Institute and the coordinator of student and faculty development cell will be the responsible for providing data for this template. Next metric, 3.1.4, number of JRFs, SRFs, postdoctoral fellows, research associate and other research fellows in the institution enrolled during the year. So here we have to provide the data where particular junior research fellows or senior research fellows, any research associate assistant we have enrolled in particular this academic year. So that detail we have to provide here. So name of the research fellow, year of their enrollment, particular enrollment year, duration of the fellowship means for the which project he or she has been appointed and for the which period, type of fellowship that indicates either SRF, JRF, senior coordinator, research associate, research assistant, that we have to fill in this column. Granting agency, who is giving the financial support for this JRF and SRF, so that we have to provide. Along with that, if he or she is qualifying in any exams like NET and GATE, so that we have to provide in the last column. Now for this metric also, we have set up certain targets. So for entire year, at least we have to enroll 12 JRF or SRFs or to achieving these targets. So minimum requirement will be the 12. So director research and all the HOIs and additional register has to keep in mind regarding these targets and goals. So in the support of the document, we have to upload list of teachers and fellows and their fellowship details, e-copies of fellowship award letters, registration and guide mentor allocation by the institution, institutional data in prescribed format as per the data template, and any other relevant document that we have to upload. So this is about the 3.1.4 regarding the enrollment of indicator 3.1.5, that is university has the following facilities. Answer where we have to provide details about the what type of facility we have. So they have given certain facilities like animal house, museums, media laboratory, business labs, e-resource studios, research and statistical databases, health informatics, clinical trial center, certain type of information we can add up in that. Here, just for the knowledge, just for the input, I have just explained that here we can include the museum of each and every lab which we have in our institution. So last time we have missed that, so we can add these museums in this AQR which we have having in different laboratories, so that we can include here. So this information has to be provided in this given data template, that name of particular facilities, year of establishment of that particular facilities, and the link of supporting photos or videos for that. So here we have to upload videos and geotech photographs, list of facilities provided by the university and the year of establishment as per the data template, list of facilities added in the current academic year. This is the new point where you have to keep in mind that in particular current academic year, which facilities we have included, that we have to list down. In that, director research and head of the institution of the entire institution has to be carried out this activity. Next metric, that is 3.1.6, number of departments with recognition by ICMR, CAR, DST, FIST, DBT, MCI, DCI, PCI, AICTE, IUS, NSCO, WHO, NIH, etc., and other similar recognition by the national and international agencies. But here we have to exclude the mandatory recognition by the regulatory councils for UG and PG programs. So except that, if we are getting any recognition, that we have to provide the data in that given format. So in that, name of the department of particular recognition, name of the scheme under which we have recognized, name of the funding agency, year of award, funds provided, and duration of that particular award. So here, this also, we have set up certain targets for that. At least, we have to achieve minimum 50% of department which we are running, that needs to be recognized with particular agencies. Okay, here we have to include that department which are offering the academic programs. So all out of the total number of departments, at least 50% of department has to be recognized with these agencies. So that need to be fulfilled. In the uploading area, e-copies of departmental recognition award letters, list of departments and award details as per the data template, and any other relevant document can be uploaded. So this is about the first key indicator. Move to the key indicator number 3.2, research mobilization for the research. Metric number 3.2.1, grants for the research projects and clinical trials sponsored by non-government sources such as industry, corporate houses, international bodies, endowments, professional associates, endowment chairs, etc. in the institution during the year. Here we have to provide the data for the external funded projects provided by the non-government agencies like this. So in that, we have to provide the title of the project, name of the principal investigator, name of the funding agency, type, whether it is government or non-government, department of principal investigator, year of award, funds, and duration of the project for which is granted. In upload section, e-copies of the grant award letters for research projects sponsored by non-government organization, list of the project and grant details as per the data template, and any other information we can upload for that. So in this section, we have to upload the information which is which are the extramural funding by the non-government agencies only. So for that, director research, head of the institution of the constituent institutes, and CFO will be the responsible to maintain the data as the finance part is included here. So we have to maintain this data properly. In the next metric, a same question is there, but here the grant or research project or clinical trial sponsored by government sources such as industry, corporate house, international bodies, professional associate, chairmen, etc. can be included here. So here we have to mention the department which are government here. Same template can be utilized here, but here we have a target for that. So for each year, minimum 50 to 55 lakhs project has to be sanctioned to achieve our target. So that keep in mind for that. So minimum 50 to 55 lakhs project should be sanctioned for a year for the for entire university. And in the same, we have to upload the e-copies of grant award letters for research projects sponsored by government organizations that we have to include here, along with the data templates. Next metric is 3.2.3. Here we will calculate the ratio of research projects or clinical trials per teacher funded by government and non-government agencies during the year. So it will be the cumulative of 3.2.1 and 3.2.3. Here we have to provide the data which is already mentioned in 3.2.1 and 2.3. But along with that, here they are going to calculate the ratio of the total number of projects sanctioned divided by total number of teachers available in that particular year. So they are going to calculate the ratio for the funded projects against the full-time teachers. So same template can be utilized here. But here also, at least 50 to 55 projects shall be sponsored, either government or non-government per year. So that target should be kept in mind for that to achieve our goals. Same uploading will be list of research projects and funding details, supporting documents from the agencies for either the sanction letter or approval letter, copy of the letter indicating sanction of research projects funded by government, non-government agencies, or any other document can be uploaded here. So this is about second key indicator. Third key indicator, that is 3.3, innovation ecosystem. In that first metric is qualitative answer 3.3.1. Institution has created an ecosystem for innovations and entrepreneurship with an incubation center entrepreneurship cell. So here we have to enumerate the details regarding our innovation policy, entrepreneurship and their outputs, startups, incubators, entrepreneurs and other available facilities. So we have to provide the answer between 100 to 200 words regarding all these facilities. Institution. So in their support, we have to upload the geotech photographs of the facilities and innovations which we have already made. So here the responsible person will be director of research and coordinator of entrepreneurship cell to provide the data for the same. Next metric, that is 3.3.2, workshop and seminars conducted on intellectual property rights, research methodology, good clinical practice, laboratory, pharmacy and collection practices, research grant writing, and industry academic collaboration during the year. So this is again the qualitative answer where you have the answer between 100 to 200 regarding the conference and seminar workshop we are conducting based on all these points. So this is the qualitative answer. In the uploading area, we have to upload the reports of all these events which we have conducted based on the above mentioned topics, the list and other documents. So here the personal involved will be the director of research, HOIs of the constituent institutes and coordinator of student and we have to compile the data and we have to provide to the
university.
Next metric is 3.3.3, number of awards, recognition received for innovation, discoveries by the institution, teachers, research scholars, students from the recognized body during the year. This is a quantitative metric where we have to provide the data in below mentioned data template. So name of the award received for innovation, discoveries, that we have to mention in first column. Name of the faculty, research scholar or students receiving the award, that recognition, either research scholar, students or teacher, awarding agency and year of award from which for which he has been awarded. In this metric also we have set up the goal that minimum one award per institute per year should be there for the particular academic year. So for institute has at least one such innovation or discovery award in a year so that we can achieve our goal. So in uploading area, e-copies of such award letter, for innovation with the details of awardees and awarding agency. Link to appropriate details on the institute website and any other relevant document can be uploaded for this area. Another metric, 3.3.4, number of startups incubated on campus during the particular academic year. So here we have to provide the data in this template. Name of the startup, whatever the company or we have registered, so that name of that particular startup mentioned here in first column. Nature of the startup, in the which area we have created this startup, that innovation, that novelty, that we have to mention here in the second column. Year of commencement, when the startup has been come into picture, and contact information of the promoter, whoever the principal investigator or the promoter is there, that contact information about his or her name, email ID, phone number. The goal that at least two startups has to be there per year. So in a 1 year from the entire university, we have to startup. We have to start at least two startups for the achieving the goals. In the upload area, we have to upload registration letters for the new startups, e-sanction order of the university for the startup on the campus, contact details of the promoters, list of the startups, details like name of the startup, nature of the startup, year of the commencement, etc., etc., the data template, and any other relevant document we can upload here in the this given metric. So this is about our third key indicator. Now we are moving on indicator number four, that is research publications and awards. First metric, 3.4.1. The institution has a stated code of ethics for the research and the implementation of which is ensured by the following. So here this is a data template. We have to give the answer either in yes or no answer. So in the all different four questions, that is research methodology with course on the research ethics, research committee, plagiarism check, publication oversight committee. So in this particular section, we have to give our answer, that is about do we have all these facilities under the code of ethics or not. So in the uploading area, we have to upload lots of documents here. So first we have to upload institutional code of ethics document. So our institutional code of ethics should be uploaded here. Course content of research ethics and details of members of ethics committee, either it is ethical ethics committee or it's animal committee, both the details we have to fill up here. Copy of software procurement for plagiarism check, that we have to upload here. Details of the committee on publication guidelines, whether institutional animal ethics committee or ethics committee. Minutes of the relevant committees regarding committee meeting for the year with a reference to code of ethics, that we have to upload here. And data template we have to upload it. Next metric is about the institution provides incentives for the teachers who receive state, national or international recognition or award. So this is again the quantitative metric where we have to give the answer either in yes or no. They have given the four questions like career advancement, increment in salary, recognition through website notification, commendation certificate with the CAS award. So in that section we have to provide our answer. In the reference, in the support of this, we have to upload the following documents, that is a policy on career advancement for the awardees, policy on salary increment for the awardees, snapshots of the recognition of notification in the head of the HAI's website, copy of commendation certificate and receipt of CAS awards, list of awardees and list of awarding agencies, and here with the contact details for the year from where we got that particular award, that we have to mention here. Incentive details we have to upload here and data templates. So all this information need to be fulfilled here in the section 3.4.2, where director research, coordinator of student and faculty development cell, and additional register should have to take initiative for the making this success on this particular matter. Now, important section 3.4.3, that is about the number of patents, copyright published, awarded, technology transfer during the year. So in that, you have to provide the data for the name of patenter, copyright, awardees, patent copyright number, title of the patent or copyright, and year of the patent, whether it is published or awarded. So here we can include all the things, all the IPR documents like patent and copyright, whether it is published or granted, both we can include here. But here we have to take important consideration that it is observed by IQAC that number of patents we have published in the last 5 years, patents are copyright, but we have to mention the name of our institution, so when the Vidyapit deemed to be university, that has to be mentioned in that particular copyright document. So number of documents are lacking with this information. So for the now onwards, please keep in mind that whatever publication or whatever patent copyright we are publishing, kindly mention the name of our institution on that. So in many of the document, the residential address and other permanent address are mentioned. So sometimes it will not counted by name. So kindly note this point. Importantly, we have to mention the name of our institution as a Sumandir Vidyapit deemed to be university. Here also we have set up certain goals. So minimum 5 patents or copyrights per the institutions should be published or granted per year. So at least 5, either patent or copyright, we have to publish or granted in particular academic year. In the reference to documents, list of patent or copyrights and the year they were published, that we have to upload. E-copies of letter for the award or publication of patent, copyright, technology transfer document and the data template, that we have to upload here in the section of patent and copyrights. Next metrics, 3.4.4. This is about the number of PhD, DM, MCH, PhD degree in the respective disciplines awarded per recognized PhD teacher of the institution during the particular academic year. Here, they want two answers, number of PhD students and PhD students pass out in that particular year, and number of teachers which are available as guide, either PhD guide or PhD guide. So that ratio they want to calculate for particular in this metric. So here you have to provide the data in given template, the name of particular course, with either PhD, DM, MCH or which PhD degree the student is passing, name of department, name of the guide, title of the thesis, year of registration of scholar and year of particular degree. So all this information we have to fill here for the getting that particular ratio. In upload section, list of PhD, DM, MCH candidate with the details like name of the guide, title of the thesis, year of the award, award letter, etc. We have to upload it. Web page for research in the institution website. So this page we have to create in the research section regarding the number of degrees PhD and PhD pass out in particular year. Data template and any other relevant document you can upload it here. Here, control of examination, deputy registrar academics, coordinator, doctor and postdoctoral studies cell will be responsible for providing the data for this section regarding the number of student pass out and regarding the number of guides available in the institution for the guiding the students. So this is about 3.4.4. Next point is 3.4.5, number of research papers per teacher in the approved list of journals in Scopus, Web of Science, PubMed during the academic year. So here we have to provide the data regarding the publications only in PubMed, Scopus and Web of Science index journals. So we have to provide in this given template, title of paper, name of author or authors, department of the teacher, name of journal, year of publication. Here we will follow the calendar years, 2020, 2021, that we have to follow here, ISSN number of particular journal, and in the different column, we have to provide the links for the PubMed, link for the Scopus, link for the Web of Science, UGCCAL list link or the serial number and journal link. So here we have to provide 5 different links for particular that paper. And at the end, we have to provide the name of indexing database in which that particular journal is indexed. Regarding the target, as we know that we have to publish at least 2 publications per year per faculty for achieving our goals. So at least 2 papers should be there as a first author, so that number of papers can be increased to fulfill the particular metric. In the upload section, we have to upload this data template and name of indexing database. Next, in the next metric, that is 3.4.6. This is also regarding the publication, but number of teacher paper per teacher in the approved list of journal notified in UGC care list. So you have to mention the journal which is in the UGC care. So here we will not include the PubMed journals. So same thing we can provide here. So two publications per faculty should be there again. And the same information about the data template and name of indexing agency should be mentioned here. Next metric is 3.4.7. This is regarding the number of books, chapters in edited volumes and the papers in national international conference proceedings published per teacher and indexed in Scopus, Web of Science, PubMed, UGCCare list during the particular year. So here you have to provide the details regarding the books published, chapters and the conference proceeding in particular year. So here the table is given, name of the teacher, title of the book, chapter or that particular conference proceeding, title of the paper, title of the conference, name of the conference, national or international, year of publication, ISBN or ISSN number or DOI number of that particular processing, affiliating institute at the time of publication and name of publisher. So here this column is most important, affiliating institute. So here we have to mention our department name properly, followed by the name of our institution. So because the implement will be checked, this publication and book chapter, all the publication by implement. So there our institution name along with our department and institute names will be mentioned properly. Regarding the target of particular this metric, at least 20-25% of faculties should publish either book, chapter or processing in a year. So of the total faculty, at least 20-25% faculty should have publish their books or chapter in this metric to fulfilling the criteria. In upload section, we have to upload the list of books and chapter in edited volumes or book published. This as per the data template, list of the names of publisher and whether it is national or international. So this information we have to fulfill for particular this metric. Next metric is occurring 3.4.8, that is about the bibliometric of the publication during the calendar year based on the average citation index in the Scopus or Web of Science index journal. So here we have to write the calendar year which are cited properly. So we have to take care of very well of that our particular publication. So we have to increase our citations also. So we have to increase our citation by making citation of each other so that we can increase the citation index of the institution. Here in the given data template, we have to provide the details of that particular paper, number of citations in Scopus as well as in Web of Science, both we have to mention individually. Institutional affiliation as mentioned in the publication, whatever the name of public affiliation institute is there, that the same name we have to mention here. And at the end, number of citations excluding self-citation in Scopus and Web of Science, that we have to include here. In upload section, list of publication during the year, data template, that we need to be uploaded here. Next metric is about the H index of the institution for the year. Here the one data template is given. So we have to prepare the same data template for both the indexing agencies, for the Scopus as well as for Web of Science. So by calculating the formula, we can find out the H index of the institution. So this is the one template is given. So this same template we have to go with the Web of Science and Scopus also. So that we can calculate the H index of the institution. In the upload section, bibliometric of publication based on Scopus Web of Science, H index of the institution, that we need to be uploaded. Data template and any other relevant document can be uploaded here. So this is about the 3.4 indicator regarding the publication. Now next indicator is consultancy, 3.5 consultancy. And that first metric is 3.5.1. Institution has a policy on IPR and consultancy, including revenue sharing between the institution and the individuals, besides a training cum capacity building program for teachers, students and staff for undertaking consultancy. So this is a qualitative answer. We need to fulfill our answer between the 100 to 200 words. We have to provide the information regarding the our policies of IPR and consultancy, our strategies we are implementing for revenue sharing between the two institutions, the structure training cum capacity building program with appropriate fund allocation details. So whatever the program we are conducting regarding the IPR and this consultancy, that we need to fill add here also in the form of qualitative answer. In the upload section, we have to upload the minutes of governing council, syndicate, board of management related to IPR and consultancy policy implementation. And I think this is a part of our research compendium. So same minutes of meeting, we can take it for the uploading section. Link to the soft copy of IPR and consultancy policy. We need to upload IPR policy and consultancy policy in all our website. And the list of training and capacity building program we have conducted during the year with respect to intellectual property rights and consultancy, we need to list out them. So this is about the 3.5.1. Next metric is 3.5.2. This is a revenue generated from the advisory or research and development consultancy projects. Here we have to explore the patient which are related with the patient consultancy. That project we will not consider here. So we will include here a clinical trial. So whatever the projects from the MRAD, we are getting revenue generation or like consultancy. So that data we need to fill here. So name of the consultancy, name of the advisory R&D consultancy clinical trial project, consulting or sponsoring agency with the contact details to whom we are in a collaboration to get the particular revenue, year of the receiving that particular revenue and revenue generated in lakhs. So here we will follow the financial year from April to March to generate this data. In the upload section, here we have to upload the audited statement of the accounts indicating the revenue generated through consultancy and clinical trials. Chartered accountant certified copy or finance officer certified copy attested by head of the institution. So whatever money we have received in the form of revenue, so that we need to be mentioned, that we need to be present in our balance sheet, and that has to be audited by CA. And along with that, we have to upload the data template as provided here. So here, director research, head of the institution of the consultant institutes, and CFO will be the responsible for maintaining the data. This is the next key indicator, that is 3.6, about the extension activities. So this is about the ISR cell, where they are asking about extension and outreach activities such as community health education, community health camps, teleconferences, telemedicine consultancy, etc. are conducted in collaboration with industry, government and non-government organizations, engaging NSS, Red Cross, YRC, institution, clubs, etc. during the year. So shall I continue? Hello. सर मेरा तो चालू है। So this is about metric number 3.6.1, where we have to fill up the data regarding our various extension and outreach activities. So we have to fill the data in the given template. So year of that particular activity, name of activity, organizing unit, agency, and collaborating agency. So here we have to make a note that we have to write down the names of both the parties who are organizing particular event, and if it is a collaboration with someone else, so both the names should be present in this third column. Number of students participated in such activities, number of teachers participated in such activities. So both the information should be fulfilled here. In the document, we have to upload the photographs or other relevant supporting document, which should be geotech photographs. Detail the program report for each extension and outreach program with specific mention number of students and collaborating agency participated. Here we have to make a note that whatever reports we are making, the reports should be neat and clean and having the very good scan copy. So to kindly provide such type of document to the IQC. Description of participation by NSS, NCC, Red Cross, YRC, Institutional Club, etc. for the particular year, and any other relevant document in response to extension and outreach activities. So here the coordinator of ISRC will be more important to providing these documents and maintaining the all the activity records. Next metric is 3.6.2. Number of students participating in extension and outreach activity beyond the curriculum requirement as stated in 3.6.1. In 3.6.1, previous metric, we will include all the activities, whether it is in curriculum or not in curriculum. So whatever you are conducting there, all the things will be fulfilled, all the things will be included there. But here in 3.6.2, we will mention only those activities which are beyond the curriculum requirement. So only those activities we will write down here. Data template is SM and uploads are also SM as discussed in a previous metric. But here, make sure that all the photographs should be geotagged and the event report should be very good in a scan, very good in a scan file. Metric number 3.6.3. Achieve any award from that we have to mention here. So this is the qualitative answer. We have to provide our answer in 100 to 200 words in the upload section. Extension activities in the year along with e-copies of award letters, list of government and the recognized bodies that have given the awards, and any other relevant document that we have to provide. So director research, head of the institution of the consumer institute, and coordinator of ISRC will be responsible for providing the data on the same. 3.6.4, institutional social responsibility activities in the neighborhood community in terms of education, environmental issues like Swachh Bharat, health and hygiene awareness, delivery of free and subsidized healthcare, and socioeconomic development issues carried out by the students and staff, including the amount of expenditure incurred during the year. So here again, it is a qualitative answer. Provide the answer in 100 to 200 words, where we have to sensitize the things regarding our inputs in the doing the neighborhood amount of expenditure incurred during the year. So in the upload section, we have to provide geotech photographs of the all ISR activities and link for the some additional information. Here also, Institute, coordinator of ISRCL and CFO will be more important as. So this is about the end of 3.6 indicator. A last indicator, that is 3.7. First metric is 3.7.1. A number of collaborative activities for research, faculty exchange, student exchange, industry internship, etc. conducted during the year. So this is the quantitative metric, and you have to provide the data in given the template. First column is title of collaborative activity, name of collaborating agency with contact details, agency along with the proper contact details, along with their address, phone numbers, email IDs, name of participants, source of financial support, year of collaboration, duration for which a particular collaboration or linkage has been carried out, nature of activity, and link to the relevant documents. Here also we have set up the goals that shall be carried document. Okay. the last metric about the presence of functional MOUs with the institutional or industries in India and abroad for academics, clinical training, intensive, on-the-job training, project work, student-faculty exchange, collaborative research programs, etc. during the year. So you have to provide the detail about the functional MOUs. So in the data template, we have to provide the name or title of the MOU for which MOU has been created, name of partnering institution, industry, research lab, corporate house with the contact details, your commencement of that particular MOU, the reason for which the MOU has been come in the course, the year-wise list, the actual activities under the each MOU. So we have to provide the list of activities we have carried out for each year. So that we have to mention here in this column. The MOUs and link to the relevant document, so that need to be filled here. Here also we have set up the target at minimum 5 such MOUs, target 5 MOUs per institute. So in upload section, e-copies of functional MOUs with the corporate house, indicating the start date and completion date, and institutional data in prescribed format that will need to be fulfilled here. So again, here director research and head of the institute of the concerned institute will be responsible for making the document for them. So this is about the all the seven key indicator coming under the research and innovation and extension criteria. So thank you very much for your listening. So any doubt? Do you have any doubt regarding any annexer or something? Ask, or you can contact the IQC. Okay, thank you very much. So I am concluding my session here. Thank you very much.
I think today's sessions were productive, and hope you understood how to fill the AQR forms. Tomorrow I kept a discussion session at the end of all criteria. I think if you have any point, we can discuss in that session. Tomorrow we'll be joining at 11 o'clock in the morning. Till then, we'll be ending the session right now. Thank you. Thank you for attending.